Hello, this is Lucas Palmeira from Imaginando, and today I'm gonna show you how to integrate VS Visual Synthesizer with the DAW FL Studio. What I'm gonna teach you is how you can use your compositions in FL Studio and route the MIDI information and audio information into VS so you can make your own visuals for your own compositions. So let's get right into it. Okay, so I have an FL Studio project here with four channels, a kick, a clap, a hi-hat, and a bass with a DRC, and we're going to use this to route into VS. So first thing I'm going to do is assign a track to DRC that it didn't have one, so I'm going to put on track four. And this is our loop. And I'm going to start by creating the track here on track 10. I'm going to put our VS. So first I'm going to go here, choose channel 10, slot 1, and choose a patcher. On this patcher, I'm going to open our VS. So VS. Okay. So we have this on channel 10. So I'm going to start by routing the audio of channel 1, which is the kick, to our VS channel. Right now it's connected to the master, so I'm going to disconnect it to the master, and here on channel 10, connect it to channel 10. Our channel 10, which has VS, is connected to the master. So if we connect it here, we're going to listen to it, like you see now. And if we go to our VS, we can see that it's already receiving the audio here. Okay, so now let's route the MIDI. And to route the MIDI of the kick, what I'm going to do is create another MIDI out, which is on port 0, channel 1, as you can see, and copy the content of our track, of our kick track, and paste it on the MIDI out. So now, I'm sending this MIDI out is sending to channel 1, port 0. So now I'm going to go to VS, press this little cog of settings here, and choose the input port toward the port that we're sending our information, which is 0. Then here on FL Studio, press left-click mouse, events, and MIDI port 0 to send it to VS. So now we connect these two dots, and we should have MIDI, as we can see here, receiving. So just gonna put trigger MIDI, and now the kick is being triggered. This shader is being triggered by the kick. So now let's do the same for the clap. Here we have our clap. Let's turn our clap on. Right now it's routed to the master, so I'm gonna turn off the routing to the master and route it to VS. Okay. So now we're receiving audio, the kick, slap, the snare, and it's actually a clap on audio. It's already routed. So now to route the MIDI, I have to create MIDI out. Now let's change the channel to channel 2. Channel 2. And copy the content of clap to MIDI out. So now if I go to VS, I should have on channel 2 the clap. Let's choose here, doesn't matter, let's choose this shader, trigger MIDI, okay. We have our clap. And now, I think we have enough routing of audio for now, so I'm just gonna do the other MIDI. So for the hi-hat, I'm gonna turn on the hi-hat and choose another MIDI out. Now channel 3, which is the channel that I want to send it to, and I'll copy the content of the hi-hat, paste it, and right now here, let's enable it, choose a shader, which is going to be this comment, and channel 3, you can see the hi-hat is playing there, and trigger. So now we have all three playing. Finally, let's do DRC. Another MIDI out. I'm gonna turn on the DRC for now. MIDI out, this MIDI out, we want to be channel 4. and I'll copy the contents of the RC into MIDI 4. And here on channel 4, we have the notes playing. So I'm gonna choose the shader for this, and I'm gonna modulate it with some notes. So I have here this cube, which I'm gonna put it on, let's put a bright red, for example, and trigger MIDI. I'm gonna drop the brightness a little bit. And I'm gonna modulate the position with the notes modulating the position on the X. So I'm gonna put it like this. As you can see, the note is changing the position of the cube, so the cube is being modulated by that. And finally, let's use the audio to modulate something. So I'm gonna choose, for example, this dark matter layer. I'm gonna drop the brightness a lot. And as you can see, it's already being triggered by the audio, because here we have an envelope generator, which is already modulating the brightness. So if I put it to 0, it's there. But if I increase the envelope generator, it starts triggering. Or I can use also the audio modulator, and that will be dependent not only on the trigger crossing the threshold, but on the amount. As you can see, I put the threshold up and I've got nothing. And if I put it down with some gain, you can see it being modulated through audio. So this is how you route audio and MIDI into VS on FL Studio. And this was it, guys. I really hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. Remember that apart from everything I said, if you want to record and export the video on VS, remember that you have to route all the channels inside VS, so when it records, it bounces with the audio attached to it. So it was this for now. We will be doing more tutorials, so if you like our channel, please give us a like and a subscribe. That means a lot to us. I will now say goodbye.